You're watching Tag TV.
From Kashmir to Kanyakumari, India's a spellbinding mosaic of culture, tradition, languages, and an extraordinary mingling civilization. Keeping its age-old culture maintained, today, the country is taking huge strides in the path of development. Hello, I'm your host Shreya Savitar, and today in our episode of My India, we bring you some of the stories that will give a glimpse of our country's diversity. Today we'll take you to the historic town of Orchha, located in the northern part of Madhya Pradesh. Lying beside the Malwa Plateau, the town is famous for its palaces and temples built in the 16th and 17th century and has won the coveted position of UNESCO World Heritage Cities. Have a look.
Nestled on the banks of River Betwa, the ancient town of Orchha seems to have frozen in time, as many of its monuments continue to retain their original grandeur even to this day. Founded in the 16th century, the town is the brainchild of Bundela Rajput chief Rudra Pratap Singh. It was given the name Orchha, which means a hidden place due to its location amid the forests. The town features brilliant architecture in the form of beautiful display of Mughal-influenced Rajput palaces, temples, and royal chhatris. Known to be the hidden treasure of the country, the town is visited by a large number of both domestic and international tourists every year. Though COVID-19 pandemic caused a huge loss to its tourism sector, but with time, it is slowly picking up pace.
मुझे आपको ये बताते बड़ी खुशी है कि प्रथम जब वेव आई थी, फर्स्ट वेव आई थी उसके बाद, और जब सेकंड वेव आई उसके बाद, दोनों वेव्स के बाद में टूरिज्म ने बहुत जोर से रुख अख्तियार किया, बहुत तेज़ी आई, और अभी स्थिति ये है कि पूरे देश में एक माहौल बन गया है कि हमें ऐसी जगहों पर जाना है जो ज़्यादा भीड़ भाड़ वाली ना हो, नैसर्गिक दृष्टि से बहुत सुंदर हों, और एक नेचर के साथ में एक हीलिंग प्रोसेस जो है, उनका रिजुवनेशन का प्रोसेस है, वो टूरिज्म के साथ साथ जुड़ा है, और मध्य प्रदेश इसमें अद्वितीय है। तो हमारे मध्य प्रदेश के जितने भी टूरिज्म स्थल हैं, सभी जगह टूरिज्म बहुत तेज़ी से सेकंड वेव के बाद पिकअप किया है। बल्कि आप अगर देखें तो किसी भी अच्छे टूरिज्म स्पॉट पर आपको किसी भी होटल में कमरा मिलने में अगले एक माह में परेशानी होगी।
The architectural heritage of Orchha depicts a peculiar style of Bundela dynasty that ruled here from 1531 to 1783. One of the most remarkable pieces includes the 14 chhatris or cenotaphs that were built in the memory of rulers of Orchha. Grouped along the Kanchan Ghat of Betwa, each cenotaph is triple-storied but a little different in design. Among all, the most popular one is the cenotaph of Veer Singh Dev, the most successful Bundela Raja. It has a unique architecture and beautiful design. At a distance of 1.5 km from the Royal Chhatris is the Orchha Fort, which is one of the most popular forts in Madhya Pradesh that was built by the founder of the town. The palaces and temples within the fort complex were built over a period of time by successive Maharajas of Orchha. Near the fort, you can also spot a number of restaurants and cafes to satisfy your taste buds. Tourists said they are completely mesmerized by the beauty as well as historical relevance of the town.
हमको यहाँ की हिस्ट्री इतनी पसंद आई, मैं थोड़ा घर से रिसर्च करके आई थी, तो आइडिया था, पर जब देखा, महसूस किया, मुझे समझ में नहीं आ रहा था कि मुझे शांत लग रहा था, तो मुझे समझ में नहीं आ रहा था कि मैं थक गई हूँ कि मुझे शांति लग रही है, पर ओरछा फोर्ट, छत्रभुज टेंपल, राम मंदिर, सब एकदम टू गुड है, और बेटवा रिवर ऑल्सो, एंड छत्रियां भी बहुत अच्छी है, तो उसके बारे में भी बहुत हमको अच्छा लगा और वेल मेंटेन्ड।
Ram Raja Temple is a yet another fascinating site to visit in Orchha. Resembling a palace, it is the only temple in India where the Lord Rama is worshipped as a king. The grand peach-tinted building with domes was once the palace of Queen Ganesh Kumari, the wife of Orchha ruler Madhukar Shah, and was also known as Rani Mahal back then. Outside the temple, one can find a number of small shops having an alluring display of metal artifacts and woodcraft. One can also find wooden toys and wooden blocks here. Besides having a hidden treasure of spiritual tranquility, Orchha also holds immense potential for film production. Highlighting the magnificence and splendor of Bundelas, Orchha is like a small sleepy village bestowed with natural beauty and grandeur. It won the Best Heritage City Award at the National Tourism Awards 2019 and is also a part of the Golden Triangle Tour that covers some of the famous temples in the north.
India is a land where Sufism has not only flourished in its true spirit, but has also become a way of integrating different religious communities. The unity of these myriad faiths can be very well witnessed at the dargahs of Sufi saints. So, today we take you to Dargah of Jhari Baba that has been serving as a bridge between different castes and communities. An epicenter of faiths, a place where brotherhood and bonhomie between as many religions could be seen flourished and prospered at its best, the Dargah of Arif Shah Baba, situated in the outskirts of the Kanpur city, is one such melange of diversities. Away from the hustle and bustle of main town, the Dargah is located midway between Kanpur and Unnao towns. The shrine witnesses a rush of devotees throughout the day. Whether one is Hindu, Muslim, Sikh or from any other community, the aroma of the shrine serenades them into cheerfulness and a belief of fulfillment ensues in them.
मैं 2004 से आ रहा हूँ. यहाँ आता हूँ तो मुझे दिल को शांति मिलती, सुकून मिलता है. इस वजह से मैं आता हूँ. सच्चे दिल से आओगे तो पक्का होगी. यहाँ से खाली हाथ नहीं जाओगे. ये मेरा ऐसा सोचना है और देखा हुआ है मेरा.
Popularly known as Jhari Baba Shah among his followers, it is believed that the Sufi saint fulfills the wishes of all those who come here from different corners of the country. People of all religions have deep faith in the saint who throughout his entire life worked for the welfare of humanity.
ये यहाँ पे बहराइच एराइच के सारे लोग आते हैं.
पूरे यूपी से आते हैं.
हाँ, पूरी ऑल यूपी से. जिनको नहीं भी मालूम है वो भी लोग यहाँ पे जियारत करने आते हैं. कि जो भी आम आदमी जो भी मांगती है बाबा से, वो मुराद पूरी होती है उसकी. और फिर जो भी मर्जी होती है वो आके चढ़ाते हैं चादर आदर. सभी धर्म के लोग आते हैं, सिख, ईसाई, हिंदू, मुस्लिम, सब.
The Dargah of Arif Shah Baba is a perfect example of communal harmony that is witnessed throughout the length and breadth of our country. The solidarity among the different religious communities has remained a hallmark of India's unity since time immemorial. Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
Women in India's Rameshwaram, a southeastern Hindu holy town in Tamil Nadu state, are harnessing the potential seaweed farming in the shallow tributaries of the sea. Dressed in saris, the local women, mainly from the fishing community, sorted baskets laden with seaweed up the shore. Introduced by Central Marine Fisheries Research Station, seaweed farming has helped fishermen and their families to earn a livelihood by choosing an alternative career to fishing.
அதை நாங்கள் வந்து கயிற்றில் போர்த்து கொடுப்போம். அது விலங்கு கொண்டே போட்டு நல்ல விளைச்சல் கிடைச்சா எங்களுக்கு நல்ல லாபம் கிடைக்கும்.
Seaweed, several species of marine algae, has a good demand worldwide in food sector due to its high nutrient value, pharmaceutical and textile industries. A volunteer group in India's eastern Siliguri town invested all their savings for the upcoming festive season to vaccinate the underprivileged, destitute and Delhi. Delhi wagers and destitute are generally not connected digitally in India, presenting a problem in covering them for the world's largest vaccination program in the country that is mostly digital.
हम लोग करीबन 200 लोग को यहां पे वैक्सीनेशन आज करेंगे. यहां से जो हम लोग वैक्सीनेशन करेंगे, कोई रिक्शा वाला है, कोई वैन वाला है, कोई कालीबाड़ी का सामने बैठ के उसको वो लोगों के पास से पैसा लेता है और भिक्षा करता है. और ये मार्ट सिलीगुड़ी कंचनजंगा स्टेडियम का मार्ट कर्मी है और बहुत सारे लोग हैं.
Although the central government scrapped the rule for mandatory online registration for vaccination, walk-ins are often met with disappointments as the quota is over and daily wagers have already missed the whole day's work. The Public Health Engineering Contractors Welfare Association in Siliguri celebrates the Durga Puja festival with a lot of fervor and grandeur every year. However, this year they decided to hold a vaccination camp for the noble cause. Durga Puja is one of the most revered festivals in the eastern part of India, where devotees establish temporary temples for the warrior goddess Durga in every corner of the city and celebrate for 9 days. A principal and a teacher of a school in southern Kochi town have constructed over 150 houses for homeless students and their families to help them lead in a decent life. Principal Lissy Chakalakal and teacher Lily Paul of the town's Our Lady's Convent Girls School had started the initiative in 2014 to provide a house to a student of their school who became homeless after her father passed away.
We started House Challenge project, first of all, to shelter our own students, those who come without basic facilities. Then when we saw our dream is to make the society homeless free. That means to end homelessness. So in order to fulfill our dream, we started the journey of transformation by promoting a culture of collaboration and sharing. So many people began to be part of this House Challenge project. It started from our school, the management, staff, students, parents, and former students, former teachers, all are part of it.
They raised funds from teachers, students, neighbors and others and built a home for the student. Over 6 years, the principal-teacher duo has raised funds and built over 150 houses for homeless students and their families all across the town. Apart from 80 students of the school who got homes through this initiative, a few homeless families with women, children, widows and ailing family members have been sheltered by the initiative.
And next we move to Srinagar city of Jammu and Kashmir, where a cycle rally named Paddle for Peace was organized by the Jammu and Kashmir Police Department to give out loud the message of peace and harmony, as well as promoting cycling as a fitness activity. Take a look.
India is home to a number of religious groups, castes and ethnicities that live together harmoniously in the country. In order to make sure that the country continues living in peace and harmony, various events are organized in different nook and corners. One such event was recently organized in the northern city of Srinagar to bring together youngsters from all religions and spheres of the city.
मुझे लगता है कि sports की जो events ये हमारी न सिर्फ सेहत के लिए बल्कि समाज की सेहत के लिए बहुत जरूरी हैं. ये आपसी भाईचारा मेलजोल उसको भी बढ़ाती हैं और सेहत को भी बेहतर करती हैं.
Titled Pedal for Peace, the cycle rally was organized by Jammu and Kashmir Police with the motive of promoting peace and harmony in the society. Young boys and girls paddled their way from Lalit Ghat in the Dal Lake area of the city to Nishat in order to complete the marathon. The rally also aimed at promoting cycling as a fitness activity and inspire more youngsters to cycle in order to stay fit.
यह जेके पुलिस ने ऑर्गेनाइज किया था इवेंट, ये साइकिलिंग में साइकिलिंग था, इसमें प्राइजेस भी अच्छी थी, इसमें बाहर से प्लेयर आए थे, जम्मू से आए थे, लद्दाख से आए थे, बाकी दूर दूर से भी प्लेयर्स इसमें पार्टिसिपेट करने के लिए आए हैं। यह अच्छा है कि बाहर से यहाँ पे पार्टिसिपेट करने के लिए आ रहे हैं और ये साइकिलिंग यहाँ पे कर रहे हैं, बहुत ही अच्छा है।
It is through events like these that bring together citizens of all religions and communities together and strengthen the bond of brotherhood and bonhomie between them. It's been said that education is the movement from darkness to light. During the COVID-19 pandemic, many individuals and organizations came forward to help students continue their studies during this difficult time. A similar example was recently seen in West Bengal, where a teacher has turned streets into classrooms.
A teacher is transforming a remote tribal village in Paschim Bardhaman district of West Bengal by painting blackboards on walls and conducting classes for children on the streets to help overcome the challenges of social distancing and the lack of internet and electronic gadgets. From teaching nursery rhymes to educating about diseases through a microscope, primary school teacher Deep Narayan Nayak is helping these village students who had to drop out due to lockdown get a second shot at education.
We all come here for learning. Here we all very excited about education. Sir give us book, copy, bags.
जब से लॉकडाउन लगा है हम लोग का बच्चों का सब पढ़ाई लिखाई बंद हो चुका था, सब इधर उधर भाग रहे थे, कोई मार्ट में कोई इधर तो कोई उधर, ऐसे में हम लोग का यहाँ सर आए सबको पढ़ाए। आज दो साल होने चला, दो साल से मास्टर लगातार आ रहे हैं यहाँ पर, सभी बच्चों को पढ़ा रहे हैं, यहाँ तक कि बच्चों के साथ साथ अभिभावक को भी पढ़ा रहे हैं।
Not just academics, but Nayak also teaches students important COVID-19 protocols like maintaining social distancing, how to wear a mask properly and the importance of hand washing. Nayak says it's quite overwhelming to see that the children themselves came forward and participated in this initiative, thus teaching COVID-19 protocols to others around them too.
यहाँ पर जो बच्चे लोग थे उन लोगों का हर एक चीज यहाँ पर सिखाया गया है कि कैसे सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग मेंटेन किया जाता है, कैसे मास्क पहनना कितना जरूरी है, हैंड वॉशिंग कितना जरूरी है। तो इस मुहिम में बच्चे लोग भी आगे आए, वो लोग भी लोगों को सिखाया।
India ordered schools to close down in March last year to curb the spread of coronavirus. While many children in cities have been able to learn through online classes, some, like the children in Paschim Bardhaman, have gone months without opening school books. The reasons range from children not owning a smartphone, having poor mobile connectivity, to not having the money to pay for an internet connection. Examples like these were witnessed in various districts of the country where individuals and organizations came to the forefront with different ideas and initiatives to help commoners during difficult times like that of the pandemic.
Next, we bring you a few short stories about the recent developments and happenings from around the world in our section, World in Focus.
Chopstick has been used by people for more than 3,000 years in Japan. But in this kindergarten in Tokyo, there is a new experience for children who enjoy using them while eating their meals. The start of using chopstick in Japan is a mystery. Some people say it came from China, but Japanese people have perfected using it for many purposes and have even special culture and custom related to them. This company has been making handmade chopstick for over 100 years, and they have good advice about how to choose the best chopstick size to feed the hand.
この手を広げて親指と人差し指を直角に曲げて この直線距離、これを日本では1アタという単位で呼びます。これの 1.5 倍、1アタ半が一番その人の手の大きさに使いやすいサイズだというふうに言われています。
There are many shapes and designs for chopsticks, and it is up to the customer to choose the one that matches the taste and feel. There is also a special foldable set of chopsticks.
こちらは日本で開催された G7、G20 で日本政府から海外からいらした首相や大統領にプレゼントをしたお箸です。このように名前を入れてその各国の首脳の方にプレゼントをしました。例えばこれは、イギリスの首相であったキャメロン首相にプレゼントをされたものでございます。
Another interesting thing about these chopsticks is that it is made by recycled baseball bat. And to promote the use of chopstick culture, there is a special association of chopstick teacher who visits school to teach children the right way to use it as they are part of Japanese culture, an important item to enjoy Japanese traditional food and cuisine, Woshuku. Chopstick in Japan is used in many ways, like to catch, cut or scoop. Many countries are interested in learning about Japanese chopstick culture and their unique usage. Dancers swung into action at the Buenos Aires World Tango Championships as a part of the qualifying round of the tournament that brings together couples from around the world. More than 400 couples from 25 countries will participate in the competition, with judges keeping a sharp eye on these sultry dancers and a unique flair.
In some way, I think a competition is a very good way to show the dancers how they do and what they do in this period of time. Mondia every year happened here, so it's a very good chance to show up ourselves. Actually, different country dancers, they use their different body language to explain what they feel of tango. And here you can see many the different situations with the different country culture based on tango, and that would be very wonderful.
The 2021 event also features workshops, classes and exhibitions, with spectators encouraged to join the fun and shake a leg themselves in milongas or tango dance halls. Champions will be crowned on September 25th to close out the festival. These vintage motorcycle collectors in Ichinomiya, Aichi Prefecture are dedicated towards their passion for riding pre-war motorcycles. Though they are uncomfortable to ride and less safe than modern bikes, love for these vintage items does not go down a bit. All the maintenance of repair work of these bikes are done at home garage, largely because majority of these motorcycle manufacturers have already withdrawn from business or have closed down. As a result of this, replacement parts are no longer available, thus many parts of these bikes are made manually, and when the motorcycle needs repair, it may take months to fix it.
ヴィンテージのバイクばっかり持ってまして、うち4台が、プレワー、戦前のバイクになります。それで全て、動く状態にして乗ってます。僕は、周りの仲間の中ではメンテナンスが下手くそな苦手な人間で、乗る方が好きな人間なんですけど、まあ、日本にいっぱい僕のような仲間同士がいるんで、自分の苦手なところはそういう他の子で助けてくれる、サポートしてくれる子がいるんで、そういう子がやってくれて、逆に僕の得意なところは逆にサポートしたりとかって、まあ、お互いがサポートし合ってメンテナンスするっていう感じですね。
Only starting an engine involves a variety of operations. and the operation of these motorbikes depends on personal skills. These motorbikes escaped war requisition and have survived to the present day. The collectors of these bikes say driving these bikes requires the use of all five senses, and the vehicles give them a different level of experience. People are surprised to see these rare motorbikes on the street, which are typically placed in museums.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@anin.com. I'm your host Shreya Savijay, and it's goodbye from the entire production team. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.